This is Diane Gilson presenting Accounting Crash Course Part 1, and we're going to be covering some of the following things: accounting information flow in QuickBooks. And I'm going to be offering some insights along the way, as I usually do, and a reference chart. We'll be talking about accounting timeframes, how those impact what we're doing. We'll be looking at the QuickBooks company information and the reporting needs that go along with the accounting timeframes. We'll do a basic introduction on why we use accounts and how we go about using them. We'll be talking about different account types in QuickBooks, how they appear in lists and reports, and some standard numbering approaches, as well as the subsystems. We're going to be covering a lot of territory today, so we'll be having to move right through this. I'll be going through and at least taking a look at a standard chart of accounts that we've included in your handouts, as well as the secret life of debits and credits. Hopefully I can save you a whole semester's worth of accounting by giving you what I call accounting 101 in a box. So for those of you who are in the audience and are experienced accountants, you may find some of this to be fairly basic, but I'm going to try to throw in enough advanced pieces along the way to make it interesting. And these are the kinds of things that quite often, as I'm working with clients, that we need to kind of back up and cover. So this at least gets us all on the same playing field as to what's going on with our underlying accounting. So I'm going to switch over into our content and get started there. So I'm going to make this a little bit bigger on the screen. And I'm going to just start out with a couple little tips here, and something that I find, again, as I work with people. Tip number one is continually keep in mind that cost and income are two separate things. Now, this sounds pretty obvious, I understand, but particularly when people start thinking about estimates, or they think about reporting, and in different conversations, the two concepts quite often get tangled up in people's minds in terms of what they're thinking about. So the next part is going to tie into that when I talk about tip number two. We'll get there in just a second. So if you think of the freeway and think of cost and income as being in two totally separate major lanes separated by that divider in the middle, they're both serving a purpose, they have similarities, and there are some occasional crossovers, but there aren't all that many crossovers between cost and income. Even though we may see them on the same reports, the way they flow through the system is quite different. The second tip is that terminology is really very important when you're communicating and working with your accounting system and with other people in the office and your outside accountants. For example, some of the words that we find people have an issue with is account and expense. So if we talk about an account, it means it's any account within the chart of accounts, and an expense is a particular type of account. So we'll be talking about those types of accounts in a moment, and I'm going to show you something here in QuickBooks that can be confusing for people. So give me a second here and I'll get into the right QuickBooks account and show you what I'm talking about. Let's go over to banking and just write check. Now, we all know that the bottom of this particular transaction, whether it's a check or a bill or a credit card, looks pretty much the same. And you will notice right here, it says expenses. And then right underneath it, it says account. So I've talked to the people at Intuit and said, you know, why do you call this expenses when it's really the account tab rather than the expenses tab? And you'll see a little later, of course, that we can choose any account to put in here. And they said, oh, well, that would just be too confusing for people. And so I kind of laugh about that. And I go, oh, gee, a proper label, I think, is what we prefer to see here. But nevertheless, try to not let that confuse you.